Now we know that one of the sources which tell us that God created the world with Hebrew letters are the letters Ish and Isha, man and woman. And our rabbis tell us that from this similarity of Ish, man, Isha, woman, we can see that the world was created with Hebrew letters. Now definitely it needs explanation. Now, Ish and Isha, these two terms for man, husband and wife, has a lot behind. It means if you go into the letters, analyzing it through numerical value, through meanings, and so on. And this is what I want now to tell you, how important it is to know these things, because it's expense. How husband and wife should live properly. What is the task of the man? What is the task of the woman? What is the attribute of man? What is the attribute of woman? If one understands each other, definitely it makes a difference in their life. So my book, Revelation About Marriage, deals with this. And this book, I have to say, that had a great impact on Barbara Streisand. She saw my book. She was very impressed. And she sent a co-actor in Yentel to Or Sameach, to my yeshiva, which I was teaching. She sent a co-actor who was Mandy Patinkin. So the beauty of the Hebrew letters really comes out through Ish and Isha. So let us discuss now what Ish and Isha means, what we can see through the letters. Now, the letters Ish, Aleph Yud Shin, one can see immediately the connection to fire. Aleph and Shin is Esh. Now the letter Yud represent mystically wisdom. Yud, Yud Kevavke, you know, the first letter of God. Yud represent wisdom. A represent understanding. Vav represent Midot, attributes, hey, the material kingdom. Now, this is really what a man is. A man contains these four elements. The Ish, the man, has mainly the character or the attribute of wisdom. This is why he has a letter Yud in it. While Isha has the element, hey, of God in her, which is really intuition and understanding. And we know quite well, our rabbis tell us that a man should listen to his wife in matters which have to do with this world, because she has a deep insight. She can see things more because she got this intuition. A man has wisdom, he collects knowledge, he learns, he knows, but the woman develops it. You see this development of what a man gives to the woman is a shape of the letter A. The letter A is built up of the letter Dalet and Apsad Yud. Yeah, in books, Sefer Torah, the scroll, you have the Dalet and Apsad Yud. Now what we see here, that the woman gets the Yud from the Ish of the Yud, he gives the, and the woman build up the house around this Yud. Yeah, this is the shape of the hay, the shape of the house, because this is a woman. Our rabbis tell us that they used to call their wives, not their names, but Beiti, my house. Yeah, because the woman built up the house when she gets the Yud from the husband. Now, when she gets this Yud, when she gets married, now you can see beautifully how it is coming out in the Hebrew letters. You know that in Hebrew, a daughter, a girl is called Bat. Betaf, Bat Israel, a girl. Now, when she gets married, she gets the letter Yud. And from Bat comes Bait. Bait is Bat, Yud inside. And this Yud, she gets from the Ish. So, you see here, already in Ish Veisha, you see in Ish Veisha, the building up together, divinity, God, Yud and K. Yud, according to our rabbi, is a letter with which the world the car was created, Olam Haba, and this is really the purpose of the man who learns Torah, building up the spiritual world. Why the letter Hey was the letter with which God created the physical world. And this is really the duty of the woman to build up the physical world. Together, husband and wife, Yud Kei. Now, rabbis tell us something very, very interesting. That by the Ish, the Yud separates the Aleph and Shin. It means the element of fire in man is not so strong as by woman. How you can see it? That in the man you have the Yud in between, while in the woman you have Isha Aleph Shin, indicating that the element of fire by woman is stronger, which is really the source of intuition, sight, understanding, because understanding has to do with the element of fire, while Yud, Chochmah, has to do more with the element of water. So the build up of Ish and Isha clearly is different. Both of them, Aleph and Shin, the element of fire, energy, power, definitely everything is in fire. But still, those elements are different by men and women, and you can see it in the letter Yud, in the man being in the center of the name, by woman, no. So these are rabbis tell us to teach us what should be our attitude to our women, to our wives. Our rabbis tell us we have to be very careful to speak nicely to our wives and not to tease them because the elements of fire by them very easily coming up and they're easily being insulted and so on. And one has to be very careful, our rabbis tell us, in this way because of the nature of women, right? And many other things you can see also in the letters Aleph, Yud, Shin are letters which are really the first ones of God's name. Aleph, Elohim, Adnut, Yud, Yud Kevavkei, and Shin Shakai. Means that you see that the elements of men are really divine powers. The woman also have the Aleph and Yud, which is Elohim and Yud, Yud Kevavke, and the Shin and the Hey mystically have to do with the name of God, but not Yud Kevavke, by Hey Vav Yud Kei. Okay, deep explanation. But both of them have in them those elements of divinity. Now, rabbis tell us when men and women don't live according to the Torah in the right way, so that God departs from them. God cannot live in a place of impurity. And the Yud Kei are taken away, and then you remain with Esh and Esh. So from the man, when the Yud is taken away, is Esh, Aleph Shin fire, and the Isha, when the Eh is taken to Esh, so there are clashes, fighting, divorces, as a result of it, when it's not Yud Kei, when God is not in their life, and they don't lead proper Jewish life, theoretical life. So we see how many divorces we have today as a result of this departure of Yud Kei from their life. Now, it is not a joke, but maybe it is a joke that in English, Esh, A-S-H, is really something we have to do after the fire. So after the fire, Esh in Hebrew, you have Esh in English. And this is what is the result. Now, Ish and Isha, you see clearly how important they are and what they carry in them. Now, numerically, Ish and Isha, if you take the numerical value of Ish and Isha, and the two words and the joining one, it is a famous rule in Gematria. I have a book, whole book about this, explaining the rules of Gematria. So taking the two words and the total bring men and women to 620, which is the numerical value of Keter, of crown. So crown, when men and women live together, Eshet Chai, Ateret Baala, yeah, the beautiful marriage, wedding, create like a crown rounds them. This way, Ish and Isha come to the numerical value.